Marty, I have to ask you, did the Commander-in-Chief make a decision when he gave that information to the ambassador and the Russian foreign minister that perhaps lives saved might outweigh lives in danger, his own troops' lives in danger?
Well, it's if you believe the Washington Post account and the subsequent commentary that's come out of it, it sounds more plausible that it was an inadvertent boasting that he was doing in that meeting, and that he didn't really understand what was classified and what wasn't. So I don't know that you can make any claim to understanding why he did it, except that he knew it in his head and he decided to say it.
Except that we don't know why the Russians are reacting this way, right? This is another Russian media operative that is reacting on Facebook. So we don't know whether Russia is downplaying this and what it might do with the information or what advantage it might give Russia.
If you are the Russian intelligence community and you got some very critical information that you knew how to use, you wouldn't exactly advertise it.
Exactly.
So, it sort of makes sense for them to downplay what was said at that meeting. I think the more important question is, what does this do to Donald Trump's agenda and his ability to govern? He's going off on a trip to Europe, and it's going to put a cloud over that.
I mean, Marty, we asked this, I feel like a broken record. We asked this question after every semi-scandal. It was Comey last week, it was this week. I mean, because there seems to be some sort of saga every few days, I mean, does it shift the needle when it comes to pushing the agenda through Congress or not?
Well, as Kevin's great interview with McConnell showed, he is intent on sticking to the agenda he has as a leader of the Republicans in the Senate, tax reform and Obamacare repeal and replace. So I'm not sure it sets back that agenda. What it does is it makes it more difficult for Republicans to work with the White House on establishing priorities and policy. And I think that, what you really need to watch for is Republican support for this president, because nothing is going to happen until there are Republicans who decide that they can no longer support this president.
Marty, Republican Senator Bob Corker's comment stood out. He said the White House has got to do something soon to bring itself under control and in order. To use his words, how does the White House get to grips with what's happening right now?
Well, they're bringing out General McMaster, who is a highly respected person in his White House. I will say that his denial was really, of the Washington Post story, was really a non-denial denial, because the things he denied were not really what the Washington Post story said. So we're going to have a briefing today, and McMaster is still on the agenda to be at that briefing with Sean Spicer. Let's see if he has some more nuance to his comments at that.
So, Marty, we had a variety of different reactions. You mentioned a couple of them yourself, one being the Russians sort of poo-pooing the fact that the information was of any use. Senator John McCain had a very interesting reaction, I thought. He didn't denounce the president in any way. He was very, very careful to suggest that the president didn't do anything wrong, potentially.
Yeah, well, I'm not sure how carefully John McCain read the story. I will say that it is interesting he didn't have a, because he's never been shy about criticizing this president. It's not clear to me what John McCain's agenda is on this particular thing, but the Post story, if it is true, does have the potential of putting lives at risk and jeopardizing a critically important intelligence source, and you'd think he'd be pretty concerned about that.
Which is interesting, because the president tweeted this morning that perhaps he had done it for humanitarian reasons, clearly not U.S. humanitarian reasons. Marty, I want to ask you as well about the Turkey visit today. President Erdogan is going to be visiting the president in the White House. What will be the conversation?
Well, I can tell you from the Turkish side, it's grave concern about Donald Trump's decision to arm the Kurds directly. President Erdogan considers them part of the Turkish insurgency. He has had a campaign for years to bring them under control. And coming out of that meeting with Donald Trump, they're supposed to issue a joint communique, and it'll be fascinating to see what's in it, because this has the potential to really be a disaster in terms of our allies with the Turkish government.